the Astrodome in Houston, Texas.
People still remember that game.
The largest crowd ever to see a college basketball game.
It was one of the biggest moments in basketball history.
The nation's two top teams meet in the Sports Spectacular of the Year.
There's all types of great games that have happened since then, but I don't think there's been as much anticipation or excitement about a basketball game as there was for this particular one.
The year 1968, the nation's top two ranked teams, both unbeaten, were to meet for the first time. The University of Houston had a successful, though untested, program, while UCLA hadn't lost a game in 2 years.
UCLA was the most heralded basketball team in college basketball at the time. They were riding a 47-game win streak. We were number two and they were number one.
We got a scouting report before the game, and he said, "It's no use you playing UCLA. They're the best. They're the best. They're the best. You just don't have a chance."
We had never lost a college basketball game, and this was just going to be another big challenge for us that we had met.
They were the team to beat. They had the coaching, they had the players, they had the reputation, they had the history.
For Coach Lewis, the matchup was 2 years in the making. It hadn't been easy to coax UCLA down south, particularly at such an unusual location.
Coach came in and says, "Well, we got them. We're going to play them January the 20th in the Astrodome." And everybody began to wonder, in the Astrodome?
You know, we practiced in a gym of 2,000 maximum. We played in a stadium of 5,500. 55,000, it's a big difference.
To say that you're going to put an event in the Astrodome and it's not football, and you want to sell it out, and you want to promote it, and you want to sell tickets, and you want to make money, you're not going to get too many takers on that.
Basketball was a regional game. In the South, basketball was almost non-existent because it was football.
I remember watching the NCAA tournament, and they had it on late at night over the weekend. It was very difficult to catch. You know, you had to, like, really plan, and it wasn't shown nationwide.
There had never been a national televised basketball game. Nobody wanted the game. They said, "Oh, that will never work. Nobody will ever watch that."
What they would watch was the matchup of two All-Americans, legends in the making.
They pitted then Lou Alcindor, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, against me.
So it was a clash of the titans, more or less. These are two great players with unbelievable egos, and no one is willing to step aside and let the other get in front.
Kareem had basically everything that I wanted. He was the best player in college basketball. I wanted to be College Player of the Year. His star to me was shining very brightly, and I wanted to replace his star with my star that year.
In just a few moments, the largest crowd ever to see a college basketball game will watch the nation's two top teams.
I remember in the locker room before this game, before we came out, we all wondering, really, will anybody be out there?
Here's the official paid attendance tonight, 52,693, the largest paid audience to ever see basketball anywhere at any level.
It wasn't like a college arena. It wasn't like any professional arena that I've ever played in, because we had the court that was here, and then you had 100 feet before the fans.
And you had this huge area of emptiness, you know, and it was scary.
We played the game at second base in the Astrodome. It was weird. It's like playing out on a prairie someplace.
Sound bounced around. The sound would go way up to the roof of the dome and then come back down on you.
We would score dead silence. They would score dead silence. And then this roar would come down upon us, because it took that long for the sound to get from the fans to us on the floor.
I don't think either team really felt comfortable, but Elvin Hayes must have felt very comfortable. You know, he had the game of his career.
It was two baskets and a floor, and so for a basketball player, that's all you need.
There's the man they want to get it to. It's Hayes, 15-footer.
Elvin had
the kind of a game that most basketball players dream of. You know, he seemingly could not miss.
Score! Alvin Hayes cheered on by Coach Sky Lewis.
Didn't matter if the ball was in his face or not, the ball was going in.
Driven off to Hayes, the score! Hayes has 35.
And as the game gets closer and closer towards the end, we haven't hit our normal UCLA run.
We near the final minute. Houston 69, UCLA 67.
And it never happened.
Houston leads by two. Oh, Warren deflection away from Shackelford. It'll go to Houston.
The most scariest moment for me in the basketball game, and it still is, whenever I watch the old film of it. Inbound pass. I'm down there with one hand dribbling the ball around.
It's the hound and the dogs.
I'm boom, 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 boom. And there's Jabbar and Lucius Allen. They could have stole the basketball from me and made a layup.
Evan was a great shooter, but he wasn't the greatest of ball handlers. Somebody get to him and get the ball. Get the ball from Evan.
3 seconds.
There was 55,000 people in this place, and they were going crazy and going wild. And I think that it was one of the most memorable moments in my basketball history.
Coming off that floor, my legs were as heavy as they've ever been. This losing was not part of my vocabulary at all, and it hurt.
It was silence in the locker room. It was the first time that we had lost. It was a terrible feeling, terrible feeling.
The next day, and for that remaining of the week, they showed that game on TV every single day.
In seeing this game, people realized how popular the sport was, and if you made it available to its fans, they'd watch it.
It just created a euphoria in the atmosphere of college basketball that wasn't there. And I think that game just kicked the door open, the windows out, and knocked the roof off the house. What we have today in March Madness is what I think the game in 1968 opened.